Now we've uploaded the macro-enabled template, we need to be able to see it. We're back in our SharePoint site's homepage, so we need to click on Documents. Click on the Settings cog symbol in the top right corner of the screen. Click Library Settings, then More Library Settings. Scroll down until you see the Content Types section. Click on Add from Existing Site Content Types. In the small pane on the left, scroll down until you see the content type you created earlier. Click Add, then click OK. Finally, review the content types area here. You can see your template is listed along with Document. If Document has a tick under Visible on New Button, click this link, Change New Button Order and Default Content Type. Here you can set which options are going to be visible from the drop-down menu. In the Visible column, clear the tick next to Document. If you have more than one custom template to upload, you can sort the order they appear in from top to bottom here. Press OK to finish. Now we're going back to the Document section to see our template. Click on the new drop-down menu and you'll see the custom template has now been uploaded. You can now click on the template and Microsoft Word will open a copy of it, leaving the original file untouched.